Alex Ansary here for April 3rd in the year 2024. As we approach this eclipse, we are seeing violence in the streets. We are seeing wars and rumors of war. On tonight's edition of Outside the Box, we are going to be discussing some of the world events. We're going to be taking a look at the news, okay? I tend to get a little bit long-winded with a lot of my content, so this is going to be somewhat of a express show. We're going to go pretty quick. We're going to bring up a lot of different bits of information. The website is alexansary.substack.com, right? Also, solarmaxnews.com. You want to sign up for the newsletter. There's a lot of content that I kick out for free on a regular basis, okay? So I would appreciate it if you check out the content, okay? So I am producing this myself. My email is solarstorm333@proton.me. That's solarstorm. It is over at the Substack page. For years, I've been discussing this stuff, but it is very important to put valuable content in writing so that future generations can come across the content. So my next book will be an autobiography. If you're watching in Portland, okay, and you're curious to know a little bit more about some of my history in Portland, I've written an autobiography, Cliff Notes. There's a lot of suffering that I've gone through. So it is going to be discussing some of the things that are transpiring in the news. So let's get started, okay? So we are going to... Now, I would like to, of course, mention that my intention is to help people evolve spiritually with the information that I share. And I'm multitasking here as far as working on this computer, producing this show myself, but also free-flowing with what I have to say. It's very important that people understand that I'm here to expose a lot of evil that's taking place on the planet. And a lot of people are not addressing the things that are taking place. They're going around it. And they found a way to, in many ways, go along with the sickness. And I cannot. It's no sign of health to be well-adjusted to a sick society. So if people are overcoming racism, white supremacy, black supremacy, Islamic supremacy, these different types of programs that are out there, even supremacy when you're female, female supremacy, and other forms of gender-based supremacy, I'd like to hear from people, okay, if they're actually getting better. All right, so... that is enough of that. Now, at the moment that I'm doing this, I'm going to go take a look at this news tip here. So, yes, there's a pattern there of strong earthquakes and solar flares, and there's changes, as you know, in the core of the Earth, and that's going to be affecting the currents of the ocean. So that's going to be affecting Earth changes also. Okay? They've been pretty regularly putting out warnings about the eclipse. Warnings about these nuke drills in different states, including Oklahoma. Okay, really interesting stuff. Okay, so as far as additional things here. Police deploy emergency plan for solar eclipse. So you should already have food and water. But keep in mind, I've talked about catastrophobia for years. And that is that natural, anxiety that people have when there's increased solar activity. And with the eclipse energy, there is more solar energy. Maybe even if there isn't a geomagnetic storm, we're being affected by it. So you might notice in society, more people going out to the club, more shootings. You might notice periods when people act nasty or rude when there's a lot of solar flares and then act like they're not affected by the solar flares at all. So let's go to this now. The New York State Police has deployed an emergency plan regarding its response to the upcoming solar eclipse as thousands of people flock to the state to view the astronomical phenomena. On Monday, April 8th, the moon will be positioned so that the entire disk of the sun will be blocked in several states. Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Missouri, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, New York, Pennsylvania, Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. I don't watch Suspicious Observer content. I told you if you want to do a report for me, he's not apolitical. He's in the left-right paradigm. I'm not. So that's why it's hard to watch his content on Twitter. But he posted something about the Eclipse conspiracy. I watched a couple minutes, but wasn't going to invest 5 minutes in his content. Okay. So this doesn't necessarily mean, in my opinion, that something is guaranteed to happen. They're responding due to a high level of traffic. Sure, they could stage anything at any point. Okay. So I noticed, for those that are new and watching this for the first time, an increase in violence around the time of the eclipse. I came back to the internet after several years being gone, being away, basically, right? And so I know a few things about this. And I also recall drinking a fair amount of alcohol. Okay, we're going to take a few breaks between the news. I also recall drinking a fair amount of alcohol in and around the 2020 period and facing a lot of paranoia, but it was justified paranoia. It was psychic intuition that people were getting deep into the far left and far right during COVID, that it was part of design. And so I did not like my environment that I was in Colorado. And so I moved several times. Now, the website that I'm going to go to now is Drudge, D-U-R-D, Drudge Report, and we're going to take a look at what's over there. So the energy was really messed up around the summer of 2020, and I noticed situations, things of this nature, in which there were attempts to get people to fight and be super paranoid. There was fake news that was put on Facebook in the Durango, Colorado area to convince local right-wing folks, QAnon, MAGA folks, to go downtown, basically with guns, to threaten the activists, right? So I'm not for what happened in Portland, Oregon with the destruction of private property, but unfortunately, in the minds of some people feel justified in being threatening because of things that they have seen in Portland, Oregon. And a lot of people in Portland, Oregon, they weren't living as the only person of color, like me, in an all-white, off-grid community in which there was the worship of Donald Trump and Alex Jones. So if you want to talk about pain and suffering, it's what I went through. So you're talking to a hardened man that's lived through hell. Now, let's talk about this. Apple robots to follow users around homes, okay? So I don't think that I want to spend a lot of time clicking on these headlines. You know as well as I do that these are some pretty relevant stories. Let's also go back here and just scan this real quick, okay? Teenage abduction victim as she was surrendering. Chilean gangs are back in Oakland. So we have a home invasion problem. That's not good. Attack on Russian Navy. So we're just going to fly through this. We're going to fly like an eagle to the sea. And over here, so we covered the stuff in the Windows Start app real quick. Chinese rocket explodes over California. Over California. Over California. Wow. Clicking. Boom. So fireballs in the sky, solar flares, and then Clyde Lewis talks about the solar flares, and he's on his way to where? Contact in the desert, and maybe he'll talk about the solar flares and the unrest, and there will be no mention of Alex Ansary. Former friend of Alex Ansary, Ryan McPherson of Costilla and Bagosa Springs, was right that I would be ignored for years, and others would run with it. Chinese rocket explodes over California as it reenters the atmosphere. The early hours of Tuesday morning. So right now it is Wednesday at 3 o'clock Pacific time, 4 o'clock Mountain time. Okay, that's where we're at right now as far as time is concerned. And so there's a devil comet also. So we have 30 Chinese warplanes and 9 ships detected around Taiwan, okay? We don't need to necessarily click on that specific article because we have been seeing, a lot of Chinese government accused of buying off strategic island with bottled water. What is going on here? You see? And so stuff will pop up at us as we go along here tonight. Pray also for Steve Baggs, who lived in Portland, Oregon, who was nice to me once, who moved, and that's what I was going to tell you. I think that when people move from one place to another, that they can come under attack, or they could be taken over if they don't have the spiritual protection to deal with whatever magnetic paranormal threats may lie. So he went from Portland to living on Mount Hood to being a quick hire in Utah. I've always sensed dark energy in Utah, so maybe some people that become unspiritual, when the solar cycle changes, they flip out. When the solar cycle goes from solar cycle 24 to 25, when there's a new magnetic polarity in the cycle, which occurred in late 2019 and early 2020, you have a shift in consciousness and energy, and people might move and do new things. So it's not just solar max, it's the shift in the solar minimum from one cycle to the other, where you also see shifts. And also spurts, solar energy. You might find yourself super sexual, super energetic, super creative, super spiritual, super athletic at the gym. China accused of buying off strategic island nation with bottled water. Okay, China has been accused of buying off the strategic island nation of the Maldives with 1 million bottles of water from melting Tibetan glaciers. Okay, so this is interesting to see also. Now, let's go to the book. We're doing good on time, 18 minutes. Want to cram a lot in here. And the reason I want to get less personal with my life and whatnot, you know, in this video is to encourage you to help me grow my channel. You know, I may not have the rock and roll hair like I used to, right? But I still have my intelligence and my morality. And to be quite frank with you, that means more to me, right, than looking like, you know, I'm still 25 to some of you. My friends have told me the reason why a lot of women don't talk to you, Alex, is because now you're old. And they're right. I am old now. I'm now 44. And sometimes I get contacted by women that are way older than I, and it's sad, right? You know, because I am male. It would be nice to be contacted by a younger female. But if what I'm saying about human trafficking of women is offensive, if what I'm saying about a lot of women picking bad boys that aren't doing anything to save the system, and if that's going to continue to leave me in isolation, so be it, right? Because like I said many times, I care about the women of 2075 and men because we have a karmic connection to them. So just keep that in mind. So Solar Wars 2025 is online, and the blogs are for you know what hits the fan. The topics include the following. An introduction letting you know that even before the massive Portland riots, in which there was a lot of anger, there was a massive solar flare. And right now we're seeing massive solar flares, strongest in years, not always causing geomagnetic storms, but there's still a human behavioral effect. There still is unrest. Okay. The sun affects our cycles of earthly conflict. The known studies of the geomagnetic influence over human consciousness. I talk about my own learning experience with the solar flares also. Beyond the fear of a solar event that takes out our grid, although there's a lot to be afraid of. I'm concerned. I'm very concerned. But do we want to live in fear, or should we look at God's plan in this? So I talk about going beyond fear. From solar minimum to solar maximum, understanding how the cycles affect our world and species. Now, how the powers are using the solar cycle against humanity, the powers that be. Advice and thoughts on preparing for power grid disruption. The connection between the electromagnetic shifts and the paranormal. So that section there, right there, that last one, would be one for Portlanders in trying to understand why during solar maximum you have lots of drug abuse and murders and sex crimes. These evil, evil, rotten things that mankind does to other aspects of mankind is unholy. You hear? It's not good. All right, so let's go back to the Drudge Report. I also have a section where I do talk about the ancient view of the sun. And even though I'm not really an Old Testament Christian, I do talk about some of the Old Testament beliefs regarding God, the name of God, things like that, and the sun, right? So that's there. I recognize the different beliefs of God and the sun being one, or at least God creating the sun. So that's how ancient worlds viewed the sun, how to mediate the effects of the solar cycle, page 148 right here. So that section there gets into mass meditations, and future books will get detailed into what people can do to organize their mass meditations. Combining my ideas of doing it during the geostorms with the ideas of Burl Payne, which is suggesting that we can quiet the sun, and doing that we can reduce aggression, and the ideas of Dion Fortune, which is using the solar cross or Celtic cross, along with other Christian and or Arthurian, which unfortunately at times is used for white supremacy, along with the cross. But I don't believe it just has a dark application. Solar flares and human potential, and a reprint of my first blog on the sun from 2009. So all that and more in a bag of chips, Solar Wars 2025. It was a milestone to get it going and to get it completed. So the next project, folks, is going to be in the members area at Substack, this book on advice for the true speaker. Maybe you're hitting too close to the truth and you're thinking about the underground, maybe being like They Live. This is an emergency broadcast. You know, we can talk about techs and specs, getting voice changers and strategies. But see, coming up, it's going to be more philosophy in dealing with evil and what light beings need to know rather than the technical specs of being anonymous. That is another essay. We're coming up on a time, folks, in which I think that we need to be open to truthing our community. So we've had a surge of solar activity. And with that, there's aspects of you, my friends, that are awake right now. Some of you are abnormally awake right now, but this too will pass. My dad was even nice to me recently and, you know, said that he received my book and that he'll read it as soon as possible. But he still hasn't really, I even feel my sister's consciousness briefly thinking about me. So I have the impression that my sister, you know, has heard about me. So my hope is that my sister will come to become psychic and mature enough to feel her brother's thoughts and to become motivated enough to not listen to maybe what daddy has said, to overcome male domination and the patriarchy, and to find out what is the buzz about this Alex Ansary and why the other Ansarys will have nothing to do with him. Okay, if she's a spiritual woman, one day she will become potentially curious. So we have the Drudge Report. Apple robots to follow users around home. Haitian gangs loot National Library. Is Antifa gang trial and street brawl opens landmark legal case? People watching me from Portland that have a low IQ may not realize that I've been exposing the far right for years and years and years in white supremacy and lived without a gun in a dangerous place in America. Solar eclipse conspiracy theory sweeps USA. So I don't perceive Portland, Oregon, anyone in Portland, Oregon, as being more hardcore against racism than me. And a lot of them confuse things, are confused, and think that black people don't have any institutional power, where I've experienced them with institutional power in Portland, Oregon, in the school system, actually. Shield your eyes. Solar eclipse conspiracy theory sweeps across U.S., claiming its path through biblical towns proves country is wicked. Now, I don't know what this is saying, but let's take a look. Let's take a look. Because I told you, I'm very on edge about what this is going to do to people. And we saw Charlottesville in 2017, and I dealt with some haters that became possessed in my understanding from entities, and I saw this rise before the eclipse in 2020, and I also came to suspect that what if there is a spiritual side of the eclipse too, though? What if it's not all doom and gloom? One wild theory is that the eclipse will cover the entire Earth and last up to 5 days. Others have pointed to verses in the Bible discussing bogus claims. Anybody can take things in the Bible and go weird with it. On TikTok, it was claimed that the solar eclipse will pass through 7 or 8 cities. The book of Jonah described how God demanded he go to the great city and preach against it because its wickedness has come up before me. Well, that I do agree that we need to be exposing evil at this time. There is some sort of a new beginning energy to this. And to be quite frank with you, for me, a lot of it, I planned to do more news, but I think I have to read this, was to cut the, like, there's a reason why comments are closed. There's a reason why I'm closing the book on certain old friendships. There's a reason why I've called out the G-Man and Mike Bluehair. There's a reason why I've called out my mother's family for a potential molestation of her in Aurora, Oregon. There's a reason why I've called out my father's family. There's a reason why I called out the man in the last video. If anyone was really offended by a certain video and they want to come down, I'll consider that because I'm nice. What I'm saying is, like, I've been picking up on the energy that we need to be exposing evil right now in our world, and why we're oppressed, and why women might wake up kidnapped and trafficked in 10 years and or longer. And people hating on me for talking about that are not well at all. People getting offended when I say and unsubscribing that this is a serious issue are not well at all. Okay. And I also pick up intuitively on those people that are going to unsubscribe from me in the members area on Substack when I talk about certain things. They'll take offense to it, right? Because they really don't want a show to call out their blind spots. So for those of you in Portland, Oregon, right, I'm really your best friend. I called radio stations the other day. I called Portland Mercury, just so you know. I called other places. So folks, just letting you know, I'm just going to be focused on writing and writing and writing. I'm not going to be planning on anything festive regarding this or traveling to certain areas, although I thought about it. I thought about following the path. That sounds dumb. I don't want to do it. I don't want to travel to the parties. I don't want to be around the people, the crowds. And so when they're up there looking at it, what's not being discussed, last time, you know where it was, right? Oregon. And what happened afterwards? Fires. And Charlottesville. So, like, this, they say all this area is evil. I don't disagree. That area is evil. But is there going to be an enlightenment from this? Or is there going to be a zombie apocalypse? How many of you are going to track the murder rate? We're going to look back on this video. Okay, look at murder rate. Also, look at births. Look at how many babies end up born in 9 months after this last month. So March had the heavy sexual energy. Look at babies born around December 2024. October, or Iran, may launch October-style revenge attack on Israel and hit targets in the UK. So we're going to go there now. How are you all doing? Are you okay? Do you need to take a break? Do you need me to ohm for you? Here. All right. Got that out of my system. No drinking tonight, folks. I drank 3 times this week. And if I was in Portland somewhere, I'd be getting the cheap cannabis, but I'm about to go off my cannabis due to financial restraints. This is not a call to action. I'm a poor man. I am a poor man in the New World Order. And I've been more accurate about a number of things than a lot of people that make decent money, that have homes and relationships that lie to you. So I'm going to be working this year on releasing at least 1 to 2 more books by December, okay? And we'll do this new show once a week where we'll pull up Drudge Report, but we're not going to go to InfoWars. We're not going to go to Rents. We will, on occasion, in some circumstances, take a look at what Clyde Lewis has going on, but I'm not a fan of his. But it seems like Clyde Lewis isn't about to let me be the only guy to discuss, but I will be the only guy to discuss the Solar Flares and Islamic false flags. I will be the only guy to talk about, you know, the Chinese invasion and events that may kick off to that, from that, in and around 2025. Events that lead to that. I will talk about Russia not being some sort of opposition to the New World Order. I will talk about many innocent refugees, but also not be pro, like, full-on open borders, you know. So let's take a look at this. They're saying that Iran is going to be attacked very soon, or Israel, rather, by Iran. Okay, so we've got that understood, where we are with that. So lots of things coming at us regarding robots, deep fakes, and I wonder if what happened in... So we had a recent event in Russia, for those that didn't hear me recently, that are just not paying attention to the news. And the day before, I was on Coast to Coast AM, and they cut me off. And the guy was like, thanks, Alex. And I talked about how I believe a trap's coming for refugees in America's future. Let me just bring myself back up here. And so I said that I basically worry for the safety of others. Not everybody's a terrorist. I talked about certain things. Okay. And I talked about how we need to evolve beyond the ninth gate of this matrix. Okay. And there's plenty of things that George could have asked me to do a real expose on the solar flares. And there's ways in which the coast-to-coast producers didn't properly prepare for the show also on their end, nor did they want to use Zoom. They were okay with the cell phone, but yet they weren't really okay with the cell phone, and they ended my appearance on Coast to Coast AM. So I'm keeping it cool and together, but there's a part of me that's a little, you know, perturbed seeing Clyde Lewis act like, you know, there's a lot of people out there that people think are kind folks, you know, and so I remember being told in one phone call, oh, it's all about the money. There is no truth movement. But in some cases, people show that they're projecting, and that's where they're at. And that's very much how I see the Coast to Coast show right now, as one that is, you know, in it for the money a little bit too much. And a lot of old fans of Art Bell miss the show, what it used to be. And that's what I grew up listening to with Grandma Ruth in Longview, Washington, the Coast to Coast Art Bell show. Okay. Now, let's go over here and continue taking a look further. For those watching in Portland, Oregon that are not left or right and don't like what is happening with regards to Portland, Oregon, I did call out left-wing violence in 2010, and it was a difficult thing to do because it didn't attract friendship energy to me at all in Portland, Oregon. And so I'm not for Trump. I'm not for Patriot Prayer. It did feel like a punch to the stomach from people to support them, Trump and Patriot Prayer, because of Portland when I was doing that years ago. It's because I'm not a Trump supporter. I don't support Alex Jones. I'm not political. I believe that if you're in Portland, Oregon, and if you care about Portland, Oregon, but if you're listening to Alex Jones, you're a dumb effer. And the reason I say that, you know, and the reason I say I'm saying this with love, to be frank, and I am, is that Alex Jones and his following, they have attacked Portland and Portlanders, and I've seen how they mock Portlanders on social media in right-wing chat rooms on Facebook, and how they talk about, you know, even how leftists should die in certain places.
And for many people on the planet, it's like another 9/11. And I don't necessarily mean...
Now, this is me fear of terrorists. 9 years ago.
I'm talking about those individuals on our planet that could get misidentified as being a Muslim, not to mention that Islam, again, is in the spotlight on a global level, being demonized and misunderstood.
This is before the fake Islamic invasion meme took off, showing that I was intuitive even then.
In a different way. In fact, in a little bit more frightening of a way. Because when the mainstream media influences people or incites people towards violence, which is what is taking place right now, it's dangerous when that propaganda sticks.
Now, here's Alex Jones
information as to how the feds are truly
promoting an attack on Moss. Right? This happened in 2015.
We'll focus on Islam.
This is going to happen again. I predicted it the first time, and the second time, and false flags. Now I'm here to show you that before this guy came into Portland,
our apples, especially our apples that are made.
I exposed Joe Biggs,
by the TSA,
who was a part of January 6th.
Disturbs me, pisses me off, and makes my stomach unsafe.
What I'm saying is, I am an intuitive. I can pick up on an intelligence agent energy, whether it be the Pete Santilli situation or others, or the guy who came to Costilla County to derail my off-grid movement. More on that in my book or on my articles.
They're able to take these over, and they are now making tons and tons of money. Now, the reason they picked Juarez could be a strategic move. This is just...
dress up like an ISIS jihadi to be as obvious as possible to show and to illustrate just how wide open the border really is.
But you just had to dress up like a jihadi, didn't you? Didn't you? And haven't we seen the United States do enough of this? I worked with a guy briefly at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse that got a job in Hollywood, and he was paid by Hollywood to stand in front of a green screen and go Allah Akbar holding an AK-47. He doesn't know whether he was featured in a movie or not. But the guy was kind of creeped out when he came back to Portland. He did valet at Rooster Steakhouse while I was busing there. And he told me that they hired him to dress up like a jihadi. And he was creeped out and he was afraid morally. He was afraid he did something wrong because he did not know where that footage was going or how it was going to be used. Haven't you seen Wag the Dog? Has anybody heard of the movie Wag the Dog? Okay, so that's what I'm getting at, and that's why this creeps me out.
Thank you, Obama, for leaving your southern borders open so ISIS can terrorize America.
So
thanks you, President Obama.
We played a lot of really good videos tonight. Thank you.
Sharia law.
We only got a few minutes left. Now let's go to that that speech, The Devil's Deception in the New World Order. We're going to skip those videos. We're going to go to the Locked and Loaded video relating to The Devil's Deception in the New World Order. It's the one on YouTube. And this is something that has played on Access TV recently. You're often hearing
I have training, but I also have it. Seen there's a lot of safe things. Mm-hmm. There's rules of nuclear war, and there's only three countries that are going to use nuclear.
Interview is from 2011.
Is not one of them. So there's never going to be a nuclear detonation. I know people have had visions of that. That's why I mentioned me also having visions of that in New York. Well, there was a terrorist explosion, but in a dream, it was more told more of a story to see this nuclear, the most scariest kind of explosion that triggers the world into a new cycle of advancement. So I know lots of people out there listening have had visions of nuclear wars, but I've had visions that specifically address that and clearly say that there's rules of war, and the Chinese have already let us know that. I mean,
sure.
The Chinese have let the Americans know that if they're ever engaged in a conflict, they'll have no other choice but to nuke 200 U.S. cities if it comes down to it. So it sticks to conventional weaponry. Nuclear weapons get involved when the war moves from America over to the Middle East as Russia comes through Syria to try to get democracy and get out Israel out of there. And that's when Israel fires off one preemptive nuclear weapon, and Russia and China both respond to that with their promises of carpet bombing any country that dares set off one nuke. It's too much of a risk. So it's not mutually assured destruction that's keeping them from doing it. It's basically here's the rules. And so that's pretty safe, in my opinion, for Americans. Don't have to really worry about that. And also the missile strikes from Russia in the East Coast were very targeted. They had very advanced weapons that could focus in and blow up a government building on a block that also had civilian apartments, for example, on the same block, and just take out the government installation and cause very minimal harm. So most of those strikes are all military strikes along the East Coast. The chaos comes from people waking up that day and turning on the TV or hearing the radio and people running in the streets and you know, going kind of postal. On the East Coast, on the West Coast, when the Japanese come in, they're coming in person.
He means Chinese.
Coming up again as peacekeepers to try to bring order because, again, these missiles fall, and in 1 hour, 1 hour's time once this starts, Americans are all going crazy. Running around, driving somewhere, not knowing what to do, totally panic-stricken. And that's where, again, you get that excuse for peacekeepers to come back in and bring order to chaos. And the Chinese will be offering us things, money, part of a new financial system, freedom from the fear that everyone will have been in after a couple of years of war. But they're never really going to take over. So as they invade through California and Oregon and Washington and start to make their way to the Rockies, America is an armed country.
Right.
And I don't mean our military is armed. Our civilian population is armed. And they're never really going to be able to successfully do that. But they will be able to occupy parts of the West Coast. And that's where you'll see concentration camps. That's where you'll be seeing people, Americans, being given a choice. Do you want to take this new financial system? And this is where you're going to see the mark of the beast.
So this was my third interview with Leon.
I have $100,000 for you to start your brand new life with if you just agree to come to this new
world order. He predicts China bringing the microchip.
Some people will do that. Some people will be in so much fear and terror that they'll just accept anything. And some people won't. And those people will get thrown into concentration.
If they're willing to trust ByteDance and TikTok, they'll trust the microchip.
And people that are watching stuff on TV, they're going to be seeing the happy Americans coming out with the Chinese for this new world order.
Look how innocent I was putting out my phone number.
See the concentration camps where Americans, especially Christian Americans, who refuse to take something like a microchip in their hand.
They will show them what they want to show them, especially when China has more control over the U.S. media.
Right. And then once you're in the concentration camp, they'll retinal scan you for, you know, just like your tag mark. And it's horrifying to what I've seen go on.
Okay. Now, there's several patterns at play. When a military invades a tribe or invades a country, there are certain things that pop up. Rape, sexual abuse, torture, human trafficking. These are some of the things that we've already heard about, stories coming out of the Middle East at the hand of what NATO forces, U.S. forces, European forces have been doing. DynCorp is well known to be involved in sex trafficking in the past, and they've still been given contracts by the Pentagon. So that McKinney confronted Rumsfeld on the fact of this in the year 2006 before the floor of Congress. So, in light of what we had seen in the past, when we know what happens when war takes place, when people are not ready, how big of a factor do you see human trafficking being a problem, specifically trafficking of women to locations outside the United States? How strong of a threat do you think this is?
It's a huge, 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 massive threat. It's not even a threat against enemies of Americans. It's a threat against fellow Americans. So you have to realize, as America, we're going to be sitting here, and sure, an earthquake might pop off over there, or some thunderstorms rip up some stuff over here, but we're still going to stick around. The moment of collapse, especially if it's from missiles falling down, whatever it is, the moment of collapse, that's when people go crazy. We're really addicted to our realities, our money, our cars, our things. If you lose all of that and you're running and abandoning the cities and cars with family or by yourself, there's a level of stress involved that most people don't have a clue about. And people will develop post-traumatic stress. People will see opportunities to steal from one another. People that haven't had for most of their lives will loot and rape and take and steal.
Right.
And in fact, as I recall, the Antichrist too, His chant when I had a vision of him was, give to yourself, above all else, give to yourself. And that's partly what brings the world into chaos, people taking what they want from another. So well, Americans are...
We've got pictures here of this drill from a few months ago involving the Russians in Colorado, and I believe this was even mentioned on the Oath Keepers website.
Yeah, so it was mentioned on the National.
This is a 2012 video.
During that time, they were trying to basically verify this information, and apparently there's pictures out now.
When the Oath Keepers were co-opted,
they're very clear pictures.
Islamic invasion meme started up. The guy speaking turned on me and blocked me on Facebook because I wouldn't get behind, you know, the Islamic invasion meme. And so when Oath Keepers started out, folks, they were like, about foreign troops in Russia and China, and that's what attracted me to, you know, the Stuart Rhodes content. Then they shifted. And so if you want to hear me talk long form about the co-opting of the conspiracy movement, you need to go to alexansary.substack.com, and those podcasts will be there.
So they are that. You can tell by their different sorts of uniforms.
So all of this pretty much ends the idea that it's a conspiracy theory that foreign troops could be stationed in the United States to restore order. And that is why that tenet that is in the Oath Keepers, we now know the evidence that this is happening. The government has invited these groups to participate in these war games. And in these particular drills and events, they're taking on terrorists, domestic enemy combatants. And the question is, what type of event are we going to foresee that's going to cause that backlash against the government? And we look at all the oppressive things that are taking place now, they're setting the stage for violence, as Ron Paul has also said. Mm-hmm. And as we go back to the pictures, and we have a lot of them, let's show them all. because this is documentation of something that's happening in real time. And Red Dawn was a movie about the Russian invasion.
Right.
A Russian This isn't an invasion. This is an invitation.
Exactly.
And so if we know they're inviting the Russians, if we know that they're inviting troops from 95, 96 countries, perhaps more. I mean, I just find that number to be astronomical. How do we know that China won't at some point be invited by our government to restore order? We owe so much money to China,
right.
And we know that certain things are being bought up in this country by mm-hmm. China, and we know we have a serious issue with the national deficit, but at the same time, this same military-industrial complex that you've turned against, that I am also against, they seem to be arming the whole world to the teeth. Have you noticed that?
I notice in this country, I notice that the Second Amendment's being attacked by our own government, like the Fast and the Furious.
Mm-hmm.
Putting tracking devices on weapons, they're allowed to go across the border.
Now, let's take a closer look at that last picture. And we see a very clear picture of the Blue Berets.
Yeah, that's Special Forces on the Russian side.
Okay.
Look over the federal papers. Get yourself educated, because the educational system in this country is in serious, serious trouble because of lack of education. They dumbed the kids down. But they want young folks that are basically, they want young folks that can't think. But they can think if we just wake them up.
Okay, so what we're going to do now, and this is the second recording because the first one, the audio wasn't up, so I'm having to work twice as hard to produce this. We're going to go to the Topoff 4 video. This was done in 2007 in Portland, Oregon. Alex Jones has not talked about it. Clyde Lewis doesn't talk about it. I've talked about it many times. Okay, and what it was a terror drill. It took place in Portland, Oregon, in which Homeland Security was present. You're going to hear the audio.
Outside the ER here at Emanuel Hospital, the staff have set up a triage section to sort out the seriousness of the injuries caused by terrorists. Terrorists set off an explosion in downtown Portland, but so as not to bring the city center to an actual halt, Portland International...
Now we're going to have to move quick on this. This is the former governor of Oregon.
National Guard soldiers who are actually trained in the area of biological, chemical, and radiological disasters. So they have been on the ground here at this site with the...
I apologize for the audio.
...trying to secure this area and actually determine all what happened. The last piece is new, and it's something that we looked at from the state level of what we would do if this event occurred, and it's called the recovery plan. One of the things that we've become aware of is that the state...
Now, you'll notice the mayor of Portland to the right of the man speaking, which is Kulongoski, the former governor of Oregon. To the far right is former mayor of Portland, Potter.
Actually captured.
And to the left, far left, is a federal agent.
People are going to leave, but there are going to be serious issues for the city. This has been a great education for...
He talks about falling into a trap.
I'm actually going to fall into a trap. If something serious is going to happen to me, and I'm going to have to trigger the succession clause of the Constitution, who becomes the governor in a time of emergency, and it's an interesting exercise after I've been...
So he's going to have to trigger the succession...
...request from the state, and then the state would request assistance from the federal. And that's what you see here.
The gayer you are, the more successful you will be in Portland, Oregon. And you can pick up on that with this guy.
All of the systems within the city and the camp being overwhelmed.
By the way, we're at the Portland Emergency Center on 92nd and Powell. 911 Dispatch Center as well.
Resources from the federal. And so Governor Kulongoski was kind of
a scene in which
taking part in this drill, acting as army personnel in some cases, manning the checkpoint, which you see in earlier in the clip.
In a way, it was a vaccine drill.
This is how we're going out tonight. Here is the press conference. Audio up.
Michael Chertoff, press conference.
Well, what's being asked is about the 9/11 drills, and he's being asked that by Ginny, and that's the question she asked, and she was asking about the odd coincidence. And Michael Chertoff, if we have audio, we may have technical difficulties beyond our control. But,
I have to confess, I've never heard anybody suggest that there were any drills that presaged or brought on 9/11. I think I have a pretty firm grasp on what brought on 9/11, and I also read the 9/11 Commission report, and I'm pretty confident that it was brought on by Khalid Sheikh Mohammed and Osama bin Laden and Muhammad Atta and a bunch of other folks, none of whom consulted with or were focused on any kinds of drills. I think we drill all the time on scenarios that we believe are possible, some more likely than others, and we do it because we want to be prepared if something happens. I think it would be a form of kind of magical thinking to believe that if we drill for something, it's going to happen because we drilled for it. On that theory, we should never have a fire drill because fire drills bring on fires. So certainly this scenario, which was planned a couple years ago, and I think we've actually used RDDs previously, reflects an honest recognition that we live in a world where there could be a dirty bomb and that we better be prepared for it. But I'm quite confident that the fact that the drill is not going to bring on an attack.
Last question up front.
One at a time, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we've had several drills from the state and local jurisdictions over the last few
days. All right, I want to thank you all for watching.
Okay, we are now back. I have the audio pulled back up. So that's a lot of video. You can find those videos at my Daily Motion channel. Those are some outside-the-box flashbacks from the past. Again, we have the man that has the vision, the Red Dawn vision, as I wrap up here and give you my final thoughts of the invasion of America. I've been intuitively concerned about human trafficking for a number of years. Also, we're looking at a few videos of me as a younger person growing up in Aurora, Oregon. If you're curious about my background and history, I have an autobiography, Cliff Notes. I just wrote a book called Soar Wars 2025, you know, and it's very important that people understand that I've been discussing these things for years and feel like, as a conspiracy realist who's not a white nationalist, who's not a leftist, who's not a right winger, who's faced homelessness, who's been a bus boy, who's worked at hotels, who's dealt with child abuse, I've dealt with a number of things that no human being has ever dealt with, period. Okay, period, ever, at all, especially in the truth movement. There's nobody like me, guys, at all in the truth movement. There are people like me that have been destroyed and bombed with drones. There are people like me that have had their lives destroyed that have been like black bagged and taken away. And I have been gifted for whatever reason to live in your society and to have an opportunity to speak the truth. And I have begged you, the people of Earth, to help me for a long, long time. And for whatever reason, you have chosen not to. Okay, so what I'm experiencing right now in this lifetime is that I am of a advanced intellect. There's no doubt about that. But in this simulation, in this reality that we're in, these are various headlines that I've collected over the years, I feel grossly disrespected by your society, and at times like this, it's infuriating. I feel like my life has been destroyed by this truth movement and by supposed truthers and neo-Nazis. And the first racists I ever really dealt with were Portlanders that treated my content about 9/11 as subpar, and it's humiliating. I don't like people that don't care about genocide. I think what you're doing is wrong. And so I highly encourage you to look at my other videos in which I go on other rants. You know, be aware of these technologies, especially if you think you know about gang stalking, conspiracies. There's no reason, in my opinion, I'm gonna do some wrap-up thoughts here, that you should be on TikTok. Okay, I also believe in rewriting the holy book, or rather adding to the holy books, rephrase. Though, extra emphasis on thou shall not sell women or be silent about women being sold. A lot of you women screw up on that part, and that's horrifying, okay? It means you're at a level of soul that isn't a certain voltage to feel empathy. Even if God has destined some people to be, like, moving on, we have some other issues here. Murder, thou shall not murder, thou shall not hang out with murderers and people that promote murder, and on and on. And then we deal with people that steal from others and the tax system. There's too many what some call status that are out there in this world that are doing wrong. And there's a lot of people in the welfare state outside of just what you would think of as the welfare state that basically have government jobs and don't really do real work. Okay, and some people have opportunities in this nation without realizing that other people are being harmed more than them. There needs to be a reform of the prison system. People should work day and night, in my opinion, to make the world a better place. Moving forward, we're heading towards an eclipse, and rather than get too paranoid about events that we can't control, I advocate that you buy a megaphone. It's a little too late to get one delivered if you're just now thinking about this, but this is why you need to listen to my YouTube channel, Portlanders, and follow me there. I advocate that you buy a megaphone, that you start a YouTube channel, You can even get a t-shirt and start a new channel or Substack page for free, and you can truth your community. You can even use CapCut, which I'm using now, and you can use a voice changer. You can anonymously get cards from Vistaprint, not a call to action to be their customer, but you can go out and make a change in your community. And it very much is Michael Jackson's Man in the Mirror, okay? Now, I don't know if we should go out tonight with that. Seems that we should. A lot of people are in a habit right now of blaming things outside of themselves, people outside of themselves, and not taking accountability. And, you know, I don't agree with certain people out there that I have promoted, or they don't necessarily agree with me on some things, but I promoted people that are not popular because they promote accountability. And so when it comes to Portland, Oregon, and the things, this is my closing thought. Portland, Oregon has dug its own ditch, sadly. We can blame till the cows come home, the New World Order, the government, the right wingers, white supremacists, but until you and other cities look in the mirror as to how you've done things for a long, long time and the people whose back you've turned on, until there's accountability for the past, until there's healing of the past, people are going to continue to make the same mistakes. Okay? And so there's a lot of healing that needs to be done as far as I'm concerned with America, the world, and Portland. And so in the meantime, while I wait for that day, if it ever does come, I have information for you to share and ideas for you to think about. So, as Michael Jackson says, man in the mirror, we need to look in the mirror and find out what we need to change in order to live in that free world. And so here we go. Let's fire off this video.
I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the collar bone, my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them need? A son of disregard, a broken bottle top, and one man's soul.
Stay alive, your body starts to shiver.